Mexico, our south of the border neighbor, is a country of vast varieties from tropical to desert climate, coastal to mountainous terrain, and from corn maize to hot salsa. Mexico is slightly less than three times the state of Texas. It counts with approximately 110 million people, of which half are under the age of 26. Its main religion is Roman Catholicism at 90%, Protestant with 6%, and other religions at 4%. Mexico is a country rich in natural resources, such as petroleum and silver. It is also a major producer of the world's grain products. In general, Mexicans are known for their hospitality and polite manner. The family is central to their culture. Mexico is famous for its hot sun and bright colors, but it's still a spiritually dark country in need of the light of the gospel. The Lord gave me the privilege of growing up in a Christian home. My parents instructed us in the things of the Lord and were active in our church. When I was 7, I remember telling my dad that I wanted to be saved. I knew that I was a sinner, and if I were to die, I would have gone to hell. My dad gave me the gospel, and I prayed to receive Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior.
I grew up in an unsafe family. I was Catholic and used to teach catechism classes, but none of that gave me what I was searching for. I was trying to find the way to know God. One day, my grandmother invited me to go to a Baptist church pastored by missionary Tap Hornor. There, I heard the gospel for the first time. I began to accompany my grandmother to church, and at the age of 17, I was saved at a Bible conference. During those services, I realized my spiritual condition and put my faith and trust in the redemptive work of Jesus Christ.
Though the Lord burdened my father's heart for the mission field when he was saved, it was several years later that we went to language school in Edinburgh, Texas, where my parents studied Spanish for a year. After graduation, my family moved to Culiacán, Sinaloa, Mexico, and began helping missionary Basilio Alfaro with the work. I was 13 years old at the time. While there, we started an Awana program, and my older brother and I worked at church painting, shoveling, pouring cement, sidewalks, and more. Our church would send out teams of 2 men to nearby cities to preach to small groups of believers on the weekend. Through this ministry, my father went to Alway and met the believers there. My father saw the need for a permanent pastor to shepherd these believers. We moved up to Alway so my dad could pastor Bethel Baptist Church. They have been there now, by God's grace, since 1997. The Lord has prospered the ministry and has been a blessing to see families saved. In this church, my wife and mother-in-law were saved, and there my wife and I learned the work of the ministry. My wife and I met in church. After she was saved, she began attending and participating in the church's activities. Through this, we were able to begin a healthy relationship while serving the Lord. We were active in youth group, evangelism, VBS, camps, church projects, and any other church activity. When the time came, Diana went to prepare for the ministry at Ebenezer Practical Institute in Hermosillo, Sonora, and I went to Bob Jones University. We were engaged the summer of 2005 at Diana's graduation and married a year later on June 23, 2006. After our wedding, we were separated for 6 months due to the visa process. Because of the delay, I decided to stop studying to be reunited with my wife in Mexico. We waited a year in Mexico and greatly enjoyed our time there. We were active in the ministry and helped with everything we could: adult Sunday school, song leading, children's church, youth group, evangelism, discipleship, VBS, special events, and many other church projects. Finally, Diana's visa came in December 2007. That same month, we returned to Greenville, South Carolina, where I finished my master's. 10 days after my graduation, our first child, Brian Hessen Horner, was born. We are currently active in 2 local churches, Iglesia Bautista de la Fe, pastored by Johnny Franco on Wednesdays, and Grace Baptist Church on Sundays, pastored by Dr. Egerdahl. At Iglesia Bautista de la Fe, we help with the youth group and the Bread of Life ministry, which reaches families for Christ through food donations. On Sundays, we help by teaching Sunday school classes, leading songs, leading youth group, going on visitation, and occasionally I have the opportunity to preach. We thoroughly have enjoyed seeing the Lord build His church at Grace. The Lord allowed us to help the pastor when he first began the Hispanic ministry, and is encouraging to see men and women that we have led to Christ still attending and growing in the Lord. We have learned much more about the ministry and people while serving in both of these churches. We would like to take what we have learned both in Mexico and in the States and apply it to the church plant in Guamuchil, Sinaloa.
Mi nombre es Jacinto Aguilar. Soy pastor de la Iglesia Bautista de la Gracia en West Columbia, Carolina del Sur. Fui misionero en México, en Hermosillo, por 11 años. Y me dio el gusto de poder conocer al hermano Brian Hornor cuando él era jovencito. Y la hermana Diana cuando estaba estudiando en el seminario, en el Instituto Práctico Benecer en Hermosillo. Los hermanos están ayudándonos ahora en nuestra iglesia. El hermano ha comenzado un ministerio de jóvenes. La hermana ha comenzado una clase de escuela dominical. Y ellos han estado sirviendo de mucha bendición en nuestra iglesia. Yo los recomiendo ampliamente. Yo estoy seguro que Dios los va a usar grandemente en su ministerio que ellos tienen para empezar en México. Yo creo que son grandes personas, hermanos muy, muy humildes y serviciales, y yo los recomiendo ampliamente para que ustedes le oren por ellos y le apoyen. Dios les bendiga.
The Lord has called our family to return to Sinaloa, Mexico, to establish a church in the city of Guamuchil. God used Genesis 28:15 to confirm Brian's calling to return to Guamuchil to continue the work of the Lord. Guamuchil is a city of about 75 to 80,000 people. It currently does not have a solid gospel preaching church. The city is about 7 miles east of Alloway. People come to Guamuchil from both the mountain and coastal areas to buy food, do business, and shop. Guamuchil is a modern-day Capernaum. It is a strategic place to begin a church because from there we can reach many more little towns and it can serve as a base to reach people in the mountains who have possibly never heard the good news of the gospel. Guamuchil is also a very lost city. It is full of drug lords who have a firm hold on the city's business and politics. The people of Guamuchil need the light of the gospel to illuminate their hearts and to guide them to Jesus.
Para mí es un gran privilegio poder recomendar al hermano Brian Hornor y a su esposa Diana. El hermano Brian ha servido en nuestra iglesia por algunos años y ha servido en diferentes ministerios de la iglesia. Y yo creo que tengo la gran responsabilidad, o si podríamos decir la sagrada responsabilidad, de recomendar a jóvenes piadosos que han decidido entregar sus vidas para servir al Señor. Brian es uno de esos jóvenes. Brian es un joven piadoso, es un joven serio, es un joven que teme a Dios, es un joven que ama las sagradas escrituras, es un joven que defiende la sana doctrina. Y por esa razón, le recomiendo con todo el corazón. Si usted puede apoyarles y si usted puede invertir en las vidas de ellos para que otros puedan oír el Evangelio de nuestro Señor Jesucristo y así la gran comisión ser cumplida, yo sé que su inversión no va a ser en vano. Aunque lo más importante es orar por ellos. Orar para que el Señor los cuide, los proteja. Orar para que ellos se mantengan firmes en la fe. Orar para que ellos sean verdaderamente la sal y la luz de esta tierra. Orar para que ellos puedan proclamar a Cristo como el único y suficiente Salvador del mundo. De antemano les agradezco y yo sé que lo que ustedes puedan hacer por ellos, sea de una forma económica o sea por la oración, ellos lo van a apreciar muchísimo. Gracias, que Dios les bendiga muchísimo y que Dios bendiga también muchísimo a los hermanos Hornor.
We are very eager to return to Sinaloa and begin what the Lord has called us to do. Our situation is unique. We will not have to spend any time learning the language and culture. I grew up in Mexico and already know the area, and the Lord has blessed me with a precious Mexican wife who fits perfectly in Mexico. Once we arrive, we will be able to start immediately with the initial steps of planting a church. Please pray for us as we prepare to plant a church in Guamuchil, Sinaloa, Mexico. Also pray and ask how the Lord could use your church or even you with reaching this city and the towns around it for Jesus Christ.